name is Alicia Tillman. I am the Global Chief Marketing Officer for SAP. We are an enterprise software company, over 100,000 employees globally, over 500,000 customers. We operate across 180 countries. And, you know, the primary focus of SAP is really two things. We have an incredibly robust suite of technologies that really help companies operate at their best. So be that technology to help marketers, to human resource professionals, heads of finance, head of technology, any of that core technology needed to run your infrastructure, your operations, your go-to-market.
On the state level, all that data is important. And in times of crisis, that data and technology allows governments to stay connected to their citizens and their employees. It allows the flow of information and it really allows for fast decision-making. I think that's critical in places like New York. Can you talk about that?
You need insights. You really need data. You need intelligence. We started at the beginning of this in offering free technology to any company to get a pulse from their employees about how they're feeling as they begin to transition to work from home, to now supporting at a state level in particular, helping companies stand up and route people to the necessary testing, to now also deploying technology to help companies and state and local governments on back to work initiatives. So, do we have the right levels of insights from people, from businesses to enable our state governments to be able to make the right decisions on when and how you should send people back to work? You know, those are tools that I think companies are going to need, and they need to be able to depend on SAP to be able to evolve as information and circumstances evolve. And to your point, I mean, that creates new products, new services, and, you know, we're definitely prepared to continue to evolve with our customers as we have since the beginning with them around this.
Working from home, you already have a lot of ideas about building teamwork, but now more than ever, we have these ideas of being a little bit flexible with our partners and finding a way at home to have compassion and empathy. And some of your thoughts on teamwork come from home. Can you just elaborate on that?
I spend most of my time normally on the road, and to be able to be here with my family during a crisis like this one, which can be scary, especially if you have little kids, that's been fulfilling. And we've learned a lot about each other, about each other's habits and motivations and inspirations. And that's been, I think, the really motivating part about this. You know, our culture is generally a very fast-paced one. And unfortunately, as a result of that, we sometimes overlook the simple steps of just asking how you're doing and how are you feeling and what can I do to help make things more comfortable for you. And I've always been a believer that when you invest that time, the success that a team member has is going to be all that much greater. And so I think it's a superpower that everybody has. They just have to slow down enough to be able to realize it.
As we prepare to go back to work, can you talk about what it means to get back to Hudson Yards? Are there unique advantages that Hudson Yards has?
I have never taken for granted my ability to work in Hudson Yards. There's so much significance to it. The largest real estate development of its kind in the country, and you know, the way that it was designed to be very community centric, all of the different amenities that are part of Hudson Yards, central location. It is a beautiful place to work. I miss the electricity and the comfort and the sophistication and the community.